To define a vector space, we need a set with two operations. One is called addition, usually, and the other one is scalar multiplication. Then the addition must be a binary operation in the set. So, you know, for any two elements in V, the sum must be a unique element in the set. And with any arbitrary elements x in V, which should be small x, not capital, and any scalar number alpha, then the product must be a unique element in the set again. So if you have that two operators with the set V, then we call that is a vector space if we satisfy the following conditions. But when you look at the first four conditions, this number 2, 3, 4 conditions actually came from the group definition. So the meaning is the addition with the set V, so the V is a group with one more extra condition, which is commutativity, right? So actually V with addition should be an abelian group. That's how, that's kind of easy way to memorize it. Okay, then the following another four conditions is about scalar multiplication. So alpha times x plus y is same as alpha x plus alpha y. So the meaning is you need to add these two elements x, y from V first and multiply alpha later. Then the result must be same as alpha times x, which is an element in V. That's how we define the scalar multiplication. And alpha times y is also an element in V, and add that two elements in V. Then the result must be same as this. That's the meaning of it. And of course, this is not always true. Okay, so there are special sets with special addition and scalar multiplication out there. And to become a vector space, they must satisfy this. Second condition in this group is alpha plus beta scalar numbers times x must be alpha x plus beta x. That's another typo, sorry. So just the same as this way. Okay. And alpha beta x, so alpha beta, this multiplication in scalar, and this is the scalar multiplication between that number and the elements from V. Okay. Then it's same as you do this part first and apply another scalar multiplication between alpha and the elements in V later, and the result must be same. And 1 times x should be x for any x we choose from V. So if our set V with two operations satisfying all these 8 conditions, then we call V is a vector space, and each element in the set V are called vectors.